Huh, your car you gonna come before my eyebrows done.
This is the princess's first royal bed. Hello friends, welcome back. I'm Connect Below. Thank you so much for watching my previous video where I kind of introduced myself, because I've been on YouTube for a couple years and I've never really done that. But I'm just really making a way for a new lane here on YouTube, and I'm just excited to get into it. So pretty much in this new direction, I want to highlight being a mom, being a working mom, being a working mom in entertainment. And we need to go back. We need to go back to the beginning. A couple videos ago, I explained how we got here, how I got pregnant, dad, all that stuff. So if you need that information, go back before you hear, okay? Because today, we're talking about my labor and delivery story. Woo! At this point, I am about 15 months postpartum. Lyric was born on St. Patrick's Day in 2023. She is my good luck charm, and I'm so thankful. Lyric is not going to make an appearance in this video today. She is with their daddy, okay? So let's get into it. So my goal going into labor was to make it as natural as possible. I did all the education in the world to prepare for labor. I had a midwife, I had a doula, I had an OBGYN, and I also took like a labor and delivery or childbirth education classes, and I also took infant CPR classes as well, just to prepare for baby. The goal going into labor, like I said, was to make it as natural as possible. I didn't want to have an at-home birth, but I wanted to have something that was very close to an at-home birth. I wanted to basically begin labor at home, labor as much as possible, and then when I felt that it was time to go to the hospital, I was gonna go. My bags were already packed, and at the time I lived about no more than 10 minutes, if that, from the hospital. So on March 16th, 2023, I had went in for my normal, what are those things called? NST, a non-stress test that they do for at-risk moms. At that point in pregnancy, I was pretty much full term, and I was going to an NST twice a week. And they were making me take NSTs because her weight was going up and down in the womb. My weight was going up and down. I was overweight also, and an African American woman. So you know, you might not know, but if you're African American woman, you're pretty much considered high risk when you have a baby anyway, because the mortality rate and infant mortality rate of women, black women, are extremely high. So you kind of already at risk when you're pregnant and black. So because I was over 30 and because I was already overweight, they pretty much made me go and do an NST weekly, twice a week. And at this specific NST, they were like, they monitor like the heart rate of the baby and the spikes in their, I'll have to like link a little clip of what an NST is because I don't know too much about it, but it just monitors the heart rate of the baby. On March 16th, they were doing the normal NST and they were like, something doesn't look right. So they sent me over to the hospital. I did a longer NST over there and for about an hour, and they were basically like, yeah, we also don't like how the levels are, but it's not super concerning. If you want, we could put you in labor now. Like, they were offering to induce me because I was pretty much, it was a week before my due date, so they were like, we can get this popping right now. But I was so impressed on Lyric being an Aries that, you know, I wasn't ready. And I hadn't enjoyed a week off from work. Like, I was really making, I had worked my entire pregnancy. So I was like, no, like, I want my week off before I become a mom. And so I was like, no, I declined to be induced and I went home. Once I got home, I pretty much got in bed. My mom came over, and it's like as soon as my mom came over, contractions started happening that night. I kind of thought they were practice contractions, and I didn't think too much of it. But as the night progressed, they became like more close. So at home, they had already began being like 10 minutes apart. And I was like, oh no, like, I'm not ready. I was ready. My home was ready. I was packed. But, like, mentally, I wasn't ready. Like, I wanted my week, you know? But I noticed that as the night progressed, our contractions just got thicker and thicker, and quicker. And I was like, okay. So I started monitoring how close together my contractions were. And at a certain point, they were about, like I said, 10 minutes apart. So I sent it to my doula and I was like, hey, like, I think I'm in the early stages of labor. Just wanted to let you know. Boom, boom, bam. And that was that. That was probably around like 10, 11 o'clock at night. So I'm just laying in bed. I'm still kind of like dealing with contractions. And I get up and go to the bathroom. And when I went to the bathroom, I was like, I don't think this is pee. And I didn't know what like your water breaking looked like, but I didn't think that it would just look like what I saw. Like, I looked in the toilet and it was pretty clear, but like I saw little specks of blood. And I was like, okay. And my mom was like, yeah, I think it's about to go down. So I was like, fine. Acknowledge that I'm really in labor, even though I was in denial about it because I was so pressed on Lyric being an Aries. Because all of my good homegirls are Aries. And my dad is Aries. Like, I love Aries. But I got back in bed when that was around, I want to say 12. That was around midnight. And I had put a towel down because I was like, I'm not about to play with whatever's going on. So I just mentally zoned out for a second. Like, I just went to sleep. And I don't even know how I went to sleep, because I was having contractions. They were anywhere from 10 to 7 minutes apart at that time. And they were beating me up a little bit. And I don't know, I just zoned out. I zoned out and I went to sleep. So that was at midnight. And I was like, okay, cool. Like, maybe when I wake up, we'll go to the hospital. So in the middle of the night, around like 4 in the morning, I wake up to basically like a gush. Like, I'm in my bed and I just feel like, and I'm like, oh, okay, it's time. Like, it's going down. So I wake up my mom and I'm like, we need to go to the hospital because this baby is coming. I already had my hospital bag packed. I threw on just like a dress and a jacket. No underwear, okay? I didn't have time for no damn underwear. I did not put on underwear. I just put on a dress, a jacket, and some shoes. And wobbled myself to the car, okay? I got to the car. We got to the hospital pretty quickly. And my mom wheeled me up to triage. And when I got there, they checked me in and wheeled me back. And the nurse was like, are you sure you're in labor? And I was like, I think so. Like, I mean, I've never been in labor before, but I pretty much think I'm in labor. Like, I'm having some pretty heavy contractions. And it's all type of fluids coming out of my vaginal canal. So I'm pretty sure I am in labor. And she had me get up and get on the bed and triage. And before I could even really even sit down, she kind of looked and was like, girl, come on, and wheeled me back to the labor and delivery area. Once I got back there, I changed. They had to check me. They had to do like some more preliminary stuff to check me in, get my vitals, stuff like that. And by that point, I believe my mom had came back into the room. And once that happened, like once I got in the labor and delivery room, like contractions started to beat me up. It's like my body was just, I don't know. It's like as soon as I got to the hospital, like they was whamming me, hitting me like hard. And I was eating them for a second. I was eating them, no medication, just working on breath work and what they call like a, I don't know. I can't even think of the term right now, but I did things to kind of distract myself from the pain. And one of those things is like moving around. You, when you're in labor, you shouldn't be like, it's recommended. I'm not gonna say you shouldn't because everybody's labor is different, but it's recommended that you move around because labor is a workout. So I'm moving around, I'm swaying my hips, I'm laying on the side of the bed. I'm moving, I'm trying to roll with it. And when it gets heavy, when the contractions get heavy, my doula gets there, the nurses and stuff at that point started to notice that my blood pressure was getting pretty high. Now my whole pregnancy, it's a little loud where I'm at, so if you hear some noise, just ignore it. So my entire pregnancy, I never had high blood pressure, but when I went into labor, my blood pressure was pretty high. Like it got pretty high. Now granted, your body is in stress, so I get it, but not only was my blood pressure high, Larry's heart rate began to be a little spotty, and that started to get scary. But I'm just, you know, tuning that out and believing that everything is okay with my baby. I'm moving, I'm grooving, I'm walking through the contractions. I'm walking through the contractions, really just trying to roll with it. But at some point, I just was like, no. So around 6 centimeters, I asked for an epidural. So up until 6 centimeters, or from midnight till, I don't know, it's probably like 6-7 a.m. at that point, I had went unmedicated, but contractions hurt. And I did all the tuning I could, but tuning out of the pain I could, but it just got very, very unbearable. And so I asked for a epidural. Now when they do the epidural, it's technically considered like a mild surgery, so they ask for everyone to leave the room so that the room can be sterile. When the doctor came into the room, when the anesthesiologist came into the room to do my epidural, she also brought a resident. Now I had given the doctors my birth plan. In my birth plan, I asked for there to be no students, so I didn't understand why she had did that, but I'm so like, just get this over with, that I wasn't even focused on that at the time. But the anesthesiologist and her resident were there putting the epidural in my back, and that resident did not know what they were doing. Like, they didn't know what they were doing. She was invited, like it was the anesthesiologist was guiding the resident, but like they just weren't getting it right. And while I'm sitting there, the contractions are beating me up. Like I wanna punch everybody around me because they're that bad. Like they were so bad. They were so bad. And I'm not trying to scare anybody, but like contractions hurt. But you can do it without an epidural. You can do it. I couldn't hold on anymore. So after so long, I'm like, okay, please, like, please, can you do it? You are the doctor here. Please, the student not supposed to be even doing this anyway. Like, that's in my plan. Like, why are y'all going against my plan? Always have a birth plan when you going into labor so that everybody know in that room not to play with you, okay? So the anesthesiologist scoots that little kid out the way, the resident, so that they can put the epidural in my back. And once they put it in my back, like, what a sigh of relief. I was like, okay, I'm about to lay down. I'm about to give me a little nap in before labor. Like, I'm good. Like, I'm straight. My mom and my doula come back into the room, and I get a quick little breather. And then my midwife comes in, and I got really lucky. My midwife that was with me my whole pregnancy, at like all my appointments, she was there. She was in the room with me for my labor. So that's not always gonna happen. I just got really, really lucky. She comes in and she's like, she checks my cervix. I am 9 centimeters dilated once I'm done getting my epidural, okay? I was like, oh, we here. We real close to the finish line. They start wheeling in all of the, like, the scissors to cut the epidural and to prepare for me to push. And they had all the equipment for me to get ready to push. And I kid you not, like, as soon as I saw that table come in, I also had my midwife in my ear, like, her Lyric's heart rate, we're not picking up her heart rate on the monitor. And so I began to panic. My doula's like, don't worry, let's move around. So my doula had me like kind of get on all fours on the table and kind of move around, and for a second, like, that helped until it didn't. So then my midwife suggested a internal monitor. Now in my birth plan, I said we could only use internal monitors in like cases of an emergency. It had got to that point. Like, it was an emergency. They couldn't pick up her heart rate with a normal monitor that sits on top of your belly. So they put the internal monitor goes on the baby. They put it in the baby's head, and that's why I was against it, because it's like a pin on the baby's head inside of you. So that was scary, but I just did it. Once I put the internal monitor in, her heart rate was there for a second, and then it went away. And so once it went away on the internal monitor, we're like, okay, she's not, Lyric is inside of me, not breathing. She has basically lost her heart rate. So my midwife is like, okay, I know how important it is for you to give birth to this baby. I know that you do not want a C-section, but we have to wheel you back to the OR. We can wheel you back to this OR. We gonna plug in this monitor. If we plug in this monitor and you in the OR and we hear a heart rate, you could push in the OR. So I was like, okay. I got back there, and once they wheeled me into the OR, like, I just lost all faith. I lost all faith. I just was just not all faith and like something was wrong with my baby, but I just knew that I was about to have a C-section, and I really did not want to have a C-section. And I kind of got mad at myself for even getting the epidural, because once they put the epidural in me, I was already 9 centimeters. Like, I didn't have much longer to go. But anyway, so I just started crying when we got to the OR, and I just knew what was going on. Like, I was like, okay, like, I'm about to have a C-section. And I was like, ugh, my body, like. So anywho, I get Will back there, I'm crying. Nobody that I know is with me in the room outside of my midwife. She ends up being in the room with me, thank God, a little sigh of relief. And after that, they're putting like something in my arm and it's burning. It's burning pretty bad. So they are putting something in my arm and it's burning my arm. And that's all I can focus on the entire time. Like, whatever y'all putting in me right now is burning. I'm like, just burns, burns, it burns. Ah, like I'm complaining. And the lady, the anesthesiologist, is like, my dear, she's a Nigerian woman. She goes, my dear, you don't hear that? You don't hear your baby crying? And Lyric was here. Like, it was literally an emergency C-section. They bloop, baby. Like, it was so fast. I kid you not even 5 minutes. And Lyric was out. And by the time I could register hearing Lyric crying, my mom was in the room by that point, and I hear her going, "Oh, look at you, oh." And so it took a while for them to bring Lyric over to me, so that started to like make me panic. And by the time that they did, it was very, very brief, and I just kind of got sad because I wasn't able to. It's not up to us how labor goes. Like, we can try our best, but they literally prepare you before labor to prepare for things not going your way, and it did not go my way at all. Like, I was so scared to have a C-section because I heard how hard C-sections were on your body. And I just didn't want that. I wanted to deliver my baby vaginally. And after, you know, delivering her vaginally, I wanted her to do skin to skin. Like, I wasn't able to have any of that experience. And I still kind of, like, get sad about that to this day. Like, 100% I get sad about that to this day. But after they kind of did some tests and cleaned her up a bit, they brought her over to me. And all we were able to do was like just like touch heads. Like, it was a quick little dap on the head, and they had to rush her to the NICU because Lyric had fluid in her lungs, and they had to hurry up and get that out. So they had basically performed like a small procedure on Lyric after she was delivered. And Lyric stayed in the NICU for like a day, and that even messed up like breastfeeding for me because they ended up giving her formula when she was in the NICU. They ended up giving her a bath while she was in the NICU. And these were all things I didn't want. I didn't want. But Lyric is here. Lyric is healthy. Lyric is beautiful. And we're good now. So that was labor. That was labor. Labor was a lot. I ended up having to stay in the hospital for 2 nights, if I recall properly. And I thoroughly did not enjoy being in the hospital after labor. Like, when you have a C-section, you do have to stay in the hospital a little bit longer because they have to monitor you, your lungs, and your legs. And because Lyric was also in the NICU, she had to be monitored as well. So it was no way I was leaving. But yeah, we had to stay 2 nights. I didn't like it. It's like every 5 minutes somebody was knocking on my door. I could not get rest. So if you're preparing for a baby, I highly suggest that in your birth plan or somewhere on your door, once you deliver, you put please limit your visits to like the nurses and the doctors, or see if they can make a plan to come together. Because it felt like every hour somebody was knocking on my door. It's like, can I get rest? Like, from 6 a.m. to 6 a.m. somebody's knocking on your door wanting something, coming to bring you food that I didn't eat because the food in the hospital was disgusting. But yeah, that was a lot. All the people coming into my room and I'm trying to rest and just mentally get over things not going my way. But I'm healthy, Lyric is healthy, we're good. So that's my birth story. You know, it started out the way we wanted it to, and it switched up on me real quick. I have been doing a lot to heal my body in this postpartum phase. I believe that a C-section did a lot to my body, and it definitely slowed down my postpartum healing. And so for the past year and some change, I have been actively working to heal my body, heal my mind, heal my core. And I had a lot of changes happen after I gave birth. So if you guys want another like sit down and I'll talk about my postpartum healing, please let me know in the comments. But that's pretty much all I got for you guys today. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe on this video, and I'll talk to y'all later. Bye.